Gentlemen, what an atmosphere we have for you here. It really is the hottest ticket in sport. We're coming to you live from the legendary York Hall, Bethnal Green. Matchroom Sport proudly present the partypoker.com Moscone Cup. Well, it's just getting better and better. Europe into the lead, 10-9. It's time now to meet our players. Ladies and gentlemen, representing the USA, please welcome Mike Deshaies. He's from the Netherlands, he's representing Team Europe, he's the king of the jump shots. Ladies and gentlemen, El Nino, Nick Van Den Berg!
This week, Nick Van Den Berg has produced arguably the greatest shot in Moscone Cup history. He now needs to go one better and produce the perfect match. Europe need one more point to make it a hatchet of titles on the bounce. 10-9, they lead the Americans. Let's join our boys in the box. Jay Helfort first up. Jim White.
Check your nerve at the door. 10-9, Europe in front, the race to 11. And Mike Deshaies looking to keep American hopes alive. And it's going to be Nick Van Den Berg in Europe winning the leg. The king of the jump shots. El Nino with a chance to hit the last nine ball in the 19th Moscone Cup. Jay, we saw the celebration after Chris Melling beat Brandon Schuff. You felt a little over the top?
Well, they were kind of acting like it was all over. And they still have to win another point. Remember, USA has won 3 out of 4 matches today.
Thank you.
And I expect this one to be just as close as our overall score.
Thank you.
Shows you the top. 10-9, it's first to 11. This is a race to 5. Van Den Berg and Deshaies. Yeah, you better take a deep breath, Nick.
Deshaies has been the American player who has struggled the most this week.
And that's why Captain C.J. Wiley left him to the back end. Now, does that strategy come back to haunt him? Good break, and I think this one will go in the corner pocket.
Just for your information, if somehow Deshaies wins this match and it goes 10-10, then the captains each pick one player to play the final match. We kind of know who that would be, don't we?
Well, we do from the American side, but boy, Johan Rutschink has options, doesn't he? There'd be a lot of players that could come out for Europe.
Well, my pick would probably be Archer versus Appleton, but first of all, Deshaies needs to find a way to get by this man.
Yeah, Mike's got to get over this hurdle.
This is the important opening shot right here. Looks good.
Good speed, nicely on the two.
Nick was already walking around the table eyeing the two ball while that one ball was still rolling. He knew it was going in.
Van Den Berg has been rock solid. This Moscone Cup. Justifying his selection. He's been very successful on the European Tour.
After the third day, we thought everything was all over, but boy, did it get exciting on this last day. But that's the Moscone Cup for you.
Oh.
Jimmy, regardless of how this match turns out, this is probably the one of the most exciting days I've ever seen at the Moscone Cup.
Never fails to disappoint, does it, Jay? One of a kind.
I mean, that shot by Chris Melling, we're going to be seeing that one for the rest of our lives, especially if they win.
First signs of pressure. There'll be more. But a missed opportunity and an easy five goes begging.
Can Mike Duchesne show how he became the number two ranked player in the United States? So far this week, he's been relatively nervous.
Yes, Mike has seen the back end of a few scores already in this year's Moscone Cup.
He's got a problem right here. He's pretty straight in on the seven ball. He's going to have to hit this one with some force.
Extension called.
And he's on the rim, near the rim. Not really where he wanted to be. He wanted that cue ball maybe another 6 inches or so off the rail. This is a test of his stroke here.
Geez, that was a pretty good shot from that position. Played with a bit of right-hand side spin as he looked at the cue ball. And now a long straight eight will really test his cueing and his nerve.
My thoughts exactly. This is where nerves show up in pool, right here.
Like I said, after Vandenberg missed that five, that was only the first indication of nerves.
He pushed this ball. He wasn't even close.
So that answers that question. He's still nervous.
Extension call.
Well, the last match, we saw the best shot of the event so far, and that may be one of the worst right there. That's got to give a lot of confidence to Nick Vandenberg.
Yeah, and especially after Nick brought him to the table unexpectedly, you bet it gives him confidence. You know, you start seeing the vulnerability of your opponent, you start to feel like you're bulletproof. And that was a big shot, a big moment, and a big shot, because you have to capitalize on that miss from Duchesne.
It's only the first game, but that could be a turning point in this match. Vandenberg had his struggles yesterday in his match with Johnny Archer.
Nine secures the first rack. It's a race to five for what would be the final point for Europe. A man that's never tasted defeat right there, Johan Rushenk, the non-playing captain. Four wins, one tie. And Mike Duchesne. Wow, what sort of negative thoughts are swirling through this young man's head as we again see the eight. Little movement, his head was up off the cue early, always an indication that you are not in control of your emotions.
Well, we know he won't win the match missing shots like that.
Now he's got a break. So everything that's happened, you can't change, Mike. Archer has been as big as any player has ever been.
Where he followed it down and... Or I'm sorry, but yeah, when he was almost straight in, he followed it.
What they're talking about is he got bad position on the seven ball, left him that long shot on the
Thank
eight.
You, rack two.
But he still should have made
USA
that shot.
USA to break, trailing one rack to nil.
There's only one way to erase the memory of all those misses, though, Jay, and you know it. You've got to be the right end of the score when the match is done.
He's going to have another opportunity here.
Made the one on the side. He's got the two near the corner pocket.
But you know, Jimmy, this is going to be a tough run out. He's going to be battling his nerves all the way.
And the crowd.
Settle down then, please.
His first shot, he's got to come across the table, miss that seven ball, go between the seven and the side pocket, and come back across for the three. A delicate little position shot here. Well, he went the low route, and he did not want to run into the nine like that.
Now he's looking at playing it into the top left corner as we look, and this will take a stroke. He's going to have to play it with a bit of right-hand spin. The four's up there.
This is a hard shot right here.
Oh, that's a great shot. That's a great shot. That'll go a long ways to reestablishing Mike's confidence. Worth another look.
Well, I think the only thing that's going to really restore his confidence is he's got to complete this run out. I think if he doesn't run out here, he cannot win this match. He must get these last five balls if he wants any chance.
Mike played Ralph Souquet last year at the MGM Grand. He beat him 6-1. That's the sort of memory that he's got to try and dig up, get that feeling back again.
Listen, less than a month ago, he won the Turning Stone Classic with 128 players.
We've said it so many times, but this diamond table is proving as unsympathetic as any table we've seen. Now Vandenberg will pull the seven back down for the eight. That's perfect. And again, this was DeShane's break, but he is a picture of a man suffering right now.
I'm afraid that miss on the sixth ball might be his undoing and the undoing of Team USA. There's silence over there in USA's corner.
You know, this was a luxury. The European captain, though, having a player like Vandenberg, who's been so strong all year. And worth much more, the experience he possesses in this event. 2-0. And he swept that one against DeShane's break. Behind Nick.
He's a good bank guy now.
And he wouldn't want it any other way.
Dennis Hatch is trying to console Mike DeShane. Nothing seems to be, I don't think he's getting through to him. He looks kind of inconsolable right now.
Well, they were walking in a melling wonderland in the last match. Now it's Nicky Vandenberg. As we again see that six that will be burned in the memory banks of Mike DeShane. It can be a cruel game, Poole, and you're out there You get all the pats on the back, all the encouragement, but at the end of the day, you're on your own, Jay. You're the one holding the cue, and everyone's looking at you to try and keep it rolling, keep them alive, give them a chance.
Well, you got to give him credit. He's out there in the arena battling.
There'll be no finger pointing at the end of this. There never is. This is just about digging deep when you need it most. Vandenberg with a 2-0 advantage. Well, he's definitely in the control seat right now. And a dry break. So this gives Mike a chance. This is what he needed. But like you had already alluded to, Jay, he's got to get out when he gets a chance.
Guys, nice and quietly, please. Now, come on.
It's a good opener, but he's a little hard on the two.
Went a little bit too far. Well, that's nice of the crowd. They gave him an applause there. He's got a little bit of a problem with this shot right here. Getting from the two to the three ball.
He's got a tough two. This two is far from a formality. He's got to cut it back into the side pocket. Oh, he's recovered it nice. Needs a nice angle on the three here.
I think he can do this if he can draw the cue ball straight back to where it is right now. Five is still going to present a problem, though.
Yeah, it looks like the middle of the table will avail position to the five. And he's got the angle on the four. Just float this down. This is all about the speed that you play the shot. And keeping that back arm steady.
He went too far. Way too far.
But he overcut the four. That was the problem. He didn't hit the four into the center of the pocket.
He's going to have to play a safety and put the cue ball behind the seven. Soft little safety. Oh no, he went the other way. This was not good. He wanted to put the five behind the seven and he didn't. I'm kind of surprised, Jimmy, he didn't go the other way and put the cue ball behind the seven ball.
Well, the reason being, Jay, it was risky. I don't disagree with you, but there was a much higher risk if he wouldn't have hidden the five trying to put the cue ball behind the seven, because he would have left the five at least this way. He doesn't leave the five, but boy, he's giving Nick an easy reply.
Yeah, Nick can stick him. He did. And he did.
And now Mike's in trouble with a capital T.
One more time, Mike Duchesne had an open rack and couldn't get past the five ball.
Extension called.
No, he wants to jump over this. Oh, no, he's going to use the bridge. What he'd like to do is kick the five into the eight and make the eight. But that's no gimme. And instead, he leaves the five hanging in front of the pocket. Another gift to Vandenberg.
At least he's got a different rest head out there, a rake head out there, something he's a little bit more familiar with, because he looked awful shaky with the X rest.
Vandenberg's got his work to do to get from the five to the six. Wow, he hit that ball good. It's going to go a little bit far, but a little farther than he expected. That table looks like it's downhill that way. He wants to cut the six bell past the eight into that upper right corner. The problem is holding position for the seven, and if he cuts it in, the cue ball's tracking right towards
extension
that side hold. Pocket.
Yeah, he's taking a lot of time here, Jay. Just can't see him attacking from this position. Very difficult six. Could try and duck behind the eight.
Yeah, he's playing safe. You're right.
Well, he's just gone a little too far. That six is nuzzled up against the nine and come to his aid. And that makes the safety from Mike Duchesne a little trickier, because that six is going to be hanging around the middle of the table.
Almost. Well, he's going to try to come off. It's very hard to hit the edge of the ball when the cue ball's all the way down table on the rail. It's hard to make an accurate hit here. Bit of good fortune coming Mike Duchesne's way.
Yeah, and he looked up at the shot clock and he had to hurry that stroke. That worked out pretty well. And you can't see enough of this. So again, just a thin cut, trying to put distance between the cue ball, get the cue ball up behind the eight ideally, but more importantly, controlling that six.
This isn't a bad safety when you leave cue ball and object ball in rail to end rail. Uh-oh. I think Nick can put the cue ball behind the 7 and 9. It looks like a pretty natural safety here. Come off the top edge of the 6 ball, lay the cue ball right behind that 7 and 9. Unless he's trying to bank this ball. He did. Jimmy, he had such a nice safety there. I'm surprised he shot. Well, he shot the bank, because if he made the six, he had the seven. He didn't have to do that. I think that was a mental error there.
Touch of desperation, maybe, but a chance for Mike Duchesne here. A long six.
Kind of like the shot he missed. Made that one. Right now, it would be huge for Duchesne just to get a game on the wire.
You can see he's dead straight on the seven, no angle with which to work.
Yeah, he should be able to make it and just draw the cue ball back out towards the middle of the table, though. Take what the table gives you. Yeah, like that. It's kind of a little bit weak on that draw stroke, but.
And the crowd's oohing and aahing.
Thank you.
Not really sure what about, but.
Here's the danger on this shot. The cue ball is going to track near that left side pocket to get position on the nine.
Corner pocket. He knew as soon as he hit it, Jay, he overcut the eight. He knew. Disaster for Mike Duchesne. To fear the worst now. Three nothing. And the beat goes on for Europe in what would be the winning match. Chris Melling stopped the fight back from Team USA. And Nick Vandenberg looking to put the final nail in the coffin. Your call, East End of London, a venue that has become famous for hosting boxing matches. And now, the most eventful pool tournament on the planet, the Moscone Cup. And Mike Duchesne would rather be anywhere than out there right now.
Well, the rousing comeback of Team USA appears to be all for naught. actually, Jimmy, I think that Nick can shoot the three, the four, and play that 5-9 combination, and that'll put him on the hill.
CJ Whitey looking on. You just wonder if...
That's what he looked at right there.
You just wonder if CJ is thinking they need a miracle right now, because that's what it appears. And they may be all out of miracles. 3-4 and 5-9.
He got the right angle here. He wants to slide that cue ball over there to the left, past it right there. See where his cue stick is? He'd like the cue ball along that line.
He's getting over to the left-hand side of the table to get
He's a little short.
He is. He's going to be queuing over the six as well, being right-handed. That's not going to make life any easier. And what he'll do is he'll pick an imaginary point on the cushion that he's lining up right now. That's the spot he'll be targeting for the five. Big shot. Bigger moment.
I think he's lined up on it pretty good here, Jimmy. He knows how he's got to hit it. You got to overcut this nine ball a little bit. If he overcuts the five, he's going to make it.
A lifeline.
He didn't overcut the five.
You know what, Jay? He didn't get the cue ball into a good spot to attack that combination. And this is a lifeline for Deshane, because he couldn't have expected Nick Vandenberg to miss that one.
Well, Deshane's been throwing a couple of lifelines, and
quiet, please.
He's still struggling. I don't know what he can do here.
Safe. This has got to be a safety.
Extension call.
Mind you, the six is in the middle of the table. Does he really want to try and knock this ball into the top corner pocket? I don't think it goes to the side. Yeah, this is a more prudent choice. Didn't get the cue ball behind the seven.
Feels like a delaying shot. That's about all.
Well, it's the thing about it is when you get your opponent missing an opportunity, you really want to punish him right away. And Nick coming back to the table, instantly he can forget about that missed nine combination.
Yeah, well, so far in this match, the only guy that's been punishing Mike Deshane is himself.
Why not?
Another look straight into the side pocket like a heart through Mike Deshane's, or a dagger through Mike Deshane's heart. Tough pill to swallow, that one.
Nick would like to roll this six ball in the same side pocket.
Well, he didn't exactly roll it, Jay, but he got it.
He stroked it in there.
Fans here in York Hall, they're starting to sense it.
He'd like to draw this cue ball up above the side pocket now. He's got to be careful. He's got to watch out for that side. He doesn't want the cue ball to hit the point.
His hand, his bridge hand moved too. Johan just trying to tell him to settle down, but his bridge hand, right away, the movement, any unforced movement, always a sign of nerves.
Can Mike Deshane win a game?
He'll knock this one in.
dead center. Mike Duchesne gets to at least bother the scorekeeper here. It's still 3-1 in favor of Nick Vandenberg. The race to five. The Americans trying to jeer their man up, whereas Johan is trying to calm his down. He knows.
That rack would have been almost the final nail in the coffin.
He kind of threw his shoulder into that one, too.
Yeah, he came off that ball.
Can't blame him for being nervous. But these guys have been in the pressure cooker so many times. This is Nick's fifth appearance. Pardon me. It was his fifth appearance coming to this Moscone Cup, this being his sixth. Every one of these situations add to the experience. Economopoulos there with a beer in his hand. So at least you know that he won't be the captain's pick. Should it go to the decider, wouldn't that be something? Bring the rookie out. Well,
these guys are both feeling the pressure right now.
Still in prime position in this match. 3-1 with the break. Two into the corner pocket. Oh, tell you what, look at the 1-9. Doesn't look like it's dead set into any pockets. Certainly an opportunity here for Vandenberg to play a vice-like safety.
I don't think you can play this combination here.
That's
what he's lining up.
Too desperate. No, he there's no way you can play this combination. If he does, it's just a shot from a desperate player.
You call it, Jimmy. That's what a desperate player does. They shoot a shot like this. I mean, he could make it.
This one's three times harder than the one he missed.
He wants to win a free game. That's what it is. Not even close. It's not even close.
Just horrible shot selection. And he got lucky. He got lucky where the nines rolled, because it's made the eight awkward now.
Duchesne, if he can reach this ball, he can't reach this ball. Well, he's stretching. Put a nice stroke on that one. That's probably his best stroke of the match right there.
Four in the middle of the table. So he does need a little angle on this three, and he may have just precious little angle on it. Get that cue ball up towards the four.
Yeah, he wants to get close to the four.
Boy, that was a good strike.
Shoot the four in the side.
That's the type of shot that Mike Duchesne has become known for. He's a power player, this young man. Youngest player on Team USA, 25 years of age.
He looks like he's kind of getting a little bit of his strength back.
You know what I think, Jay? I think he's seen some weakness from his opponent. He's seen and sensed that touch of desperation, and he wants to pounce on it.
Well, the way to pounce is to get out here.
Tell you what,
here comes the key shot.
He's perfect. He is perfect on the seven here. He should be able to float that cue ball right between the nine and the eight. Or if he wanted to, he could pull it back, pinch the pocket a bit, and even play the combination. He's got options here. Beautiful. That's a perfect shot, Mike.
It's not bad.
Tension called.
The Americans, they can't bear to watch. He's got to float this one in too. No choice.
He's got to hit this straight. We know that if the eight ball doesn't get close to that side rail going down the table, it will not go in.
Got to keep your head still. Just put a nice, steady stroke on it.
Man, he put that. He hit that with some speed.
Well, he had more cue. He had more cue ball exposed where he could get that Q-tip into it. Yeah, CJ, I don't blame you. You're starting to see what this man is capable of.
This is the first rack where we've seen him let his stroke out.
Mike DeShane has secured the last two racks. 3-2, and he breaks in rack six. And seeds of doubt have to be in the European camp. It's been costly.
Well, he couldn't have hit that shot any better.
Vandenberg beat Earl Strickland back in Holland when the only tie in Moscone Cup history was put on the score sheet. And that's his favorite Moscone Cup moment. Well, I guarantee he'd eclipse that should he win this match.
This is a huge rack for him right now.
Little angle on the five. You can float the cue ball back out to the middle of the table.
So far, he's hit every shot just right. Including that one. Like he wants to just stick the cue ball right there. That's not a bad idea. He's going to take the eight in the side next.
Around the table too.
Cue ball will roll forward off that side rail, come back almost to where the eight ball is right now for position on the nine. Oh, he got real close. He got real close to that nine ball. He likes that.
This is the last break that he'll hit. 4-2.
Well, been unfortunate on that break shot. He got a ball down, but he's got no shot at the one.
So Deshane gets out of his chair at the very least, Jay, and I guarantee you sort of messages that Johnny Archer has been throwing around in the USA practice room is just a chance. We just want a chance. Well, Deshane's going to get that.
Here's a push out. Jimmy, I think Deshane has to take this shot and do something with it.
Well, you can see his eyes darting to the far end of the table. How does he get the cue ball up there?
He gave it back. He gave it back.
Well, the five takes the bank away. So whatever Nick had in mind, we're about to find out.
Well, this is probably the biggest safety of his life right here. Well, he could have done a little better than that.
Oh, I guarantee you, Mike will be happy coming to the table and looking at this. This is a chance.
He should be able to hide the one ball and the cue ball.
Oh, he's got to be able to
put on both sides of the three here.
No, he's got to be able to put the handcuffs on him there.
There he goes. That's what you got to do. Just like that, Deshane has got the upper hand this rack.
He's gone for the short cue. We've already seen Nick Vandenberg play a jump shot. They'll be talking about for a long, long time. Here's another one. He's close to the three.
Well, that other jump shot doesn't mean much now. He's got to execute this one.
Yeah, being tall helps because you can elevate the cue, come in at a real steep angle.
First thing he's got to do is clear that three ball, which is real close to the cue ball.
No, not this time.
And he didn't.
Ball in hand for Mike.
Stop the clock.
Didn't quite get it up quick enough.
Nice and quiet then, please.
Oh, he wants a little angle here. The three's over the right-hand corner. So again, he can just pull this back.
Almost all the way to the end rail, I think. Oh, he was a little weak there.
That's horrible. That's a horrible shot.
Can he see the three ball? Oh, my goodness. Jimmy, what happened there? He just forgot to hit the ball.
That's it, please. Thank you.
I'm not sure what's going on here. Jimmy. Yeah, he made a good safety there, but that was one of the weakest strokes.
But he had so much room to play with.
Yeah, he had two diamonds at the table to play position.
We're both in there shaking our heads over this one.
He could have drawn back anywhere, and he'd have been fine. He's going to kick off the end rail, I believe. No. Another opportunity for Deshane.
Just wonder if there's going to be another twist in this tail. 4-2 in favor of Europe right now. And a chance for Vandenberg to seal the deal.
I think he's going to have to hit the end rail just before the pocket and send the cue ball three rails. Let's see. Sure. Now he's trying to draw back for position. He's very straight on this four ball. He's got to find a way to get up to the end rail and have a shot at the five. He's got to cheat this pocket just a little bit here.
Let's see.
Let's see.
Let's see. Is he going to do it? No. No. He did not do it.
Just the way we would have wanted it. Unbelievable drama unfolding here.
You called it, Jimmy. You said, what's the next twist and turn in this match?
He was going to play his shot. Then he looked to see where the referee was. This is tricky.
I don't know about this shot.
Tell you what, this might be great.
It's a stupendous shot from that position.
How did he do that? How did he do that?
As bad a shot as the previous one was. This one dug him right out. Mike, an easy kick here, but again, getting it safe.
He can see the edge of the ball.
He can see the edge, Jay. You're right.
Just can't see enough to make it.
Got to be careful of the double kiss here. If he doesn't get the desired contact on the five, it'd be tough to get the cue ball out of the way.
Every shot could be his last.
Oh, just missed it.
Uh-oh, this. He ain't going to like that. He laid that one up there.
I'm not sure if he was trying this. The way he played it, maybe he was.
No, I think he was trying to make it. This could be it right here. Well, Mike can blame himself for playing bad position on that three ball. Well, the seven will not go in the lower left corner. He's got a. I think. I'm not sure where the seven ball goes here. Is he trying to break these balls up? Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
He's done it. He's done it. Archer knows it. And so do the fans here at York Hall.
That was a magnificent shot right there.
And you know, I think Archer would have been the captain's pick, Jay. He'd have been the one coming out if it would have gone to 10-10. To win the Moscone Cup, this nine ball for Nick Vandenberg.
Get ready for a deafening roar if this one goes down.
Yeah, let's hope the roof holds up.
He almost missed that one, Jimmy. He got three rails on that pocket.
A fantastic fight back by Team USA. They won the first three matches to kick off day four here, and everybody thought, was it going to be a shock on the cards?
It looks like a rugby scrum here.
Chris Melling and Nick Vandenberg stopped the bleeding. And what a performance from Team Europe. Fantastic. The 19th Moscone Cup stays where it's been the last 2 years. The crowd will celebrate. You know they'll be toasting Team Europe in the East End of London tonight.
I think Vandenberg's glad that one's over. He was a little shaky at the end, too.
Tremendous stuff. Rico Dix, he's there. The hugs, everything.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, truly amazing scenes here. And now it's time for the presentation. And would you please welcome the chairman of Matchroom Sport and the founder of the Moscone Cup, Mr. Barry Hearn. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to invite the runners-up, please, to join us on the set now. Team USA. So, ladies and gentlemen, receiving the silver medals. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to receive the silver medals, Team USA. Firstly, can we call up Shane Van Boning? Johnny Archer. Brandon Scharf. The Hatchet Man, Dennis Hatch. Mike Deshane. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, team captain of the USA, CJ Wiley.
We got close.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, to receive the gold medals, would you please welcome Darren Appleton, ladies and gentlemen. Chris Milling. Nikos Ikonopoulos. Nils Fayen. And rightly so, hitting the final nine ball, Nick Vandenberg. The team captain of Team Europe, Johan Reising. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the coveted trophy, but most important of all, the title of PartyPoker.com Moscone Cup Champions 2012, Team Europe!
Ladies and gents, it has been a wonderful 4 days. Let's hear it again for Team America and Team Europe. I can't hear you either, but don't worry, the people at home can hear both of us. Okay. Firstly, congratulations. How on earth did this one rate compared to previous wins?
Oh, this is by far the most thrilling win ever for me. The Americans, I must say, they pulled out a real big gun today, and they came back at us with all the power. And I'm so glad we pulled it through in the end. It was hard work, but with the fans and with the team that stuck to the plan, I'm so happy, delighted, over the moon.
Let's have a word with the man that potted the ball in the end, Nick Vandenberg. La 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 la. Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
How was your ticker on that final nine ball?
Oh, you know, during the whole match, I think my heartbeat was like 220 the whole match, and Johan told me to calm down, but it was almost impossible. And that last shot, I had to break it open. It worked out perfect, but still played wrong position. But the nine ball wobbled and fell in. it must be the most exciting match of my life, but also I made a lot of mistakes, but in the end I won. Imagine, you got to do this for a living.
Wonderful, congratulations. We're going to speak to all the team members. Let's have a word with Darren Appleton next. Darren Appleton, dynamite Darren Appleton, back-to-back US Open champion. How does this compare to nights when you picked up the trophy of US Open champion, world champion as well? How does this compare to all of that?
I mean, the emotion is amazing. I mean, it's all about the team. We play the team, win and lose the team. The Americans fought really hard today, showed a lot of heart, but at 9-9, Melling played unbelievable at 9-9 to get us to the hill, and then Nick at the end. I mean, it was just a dogfight for them both, but the pressure's unreal. I mean, like, the pressure's just crazy out there. But I mean, to be part of the team, like, with this crowd is just amazing.
Congratulations. We'll have a word with Chris Melling next. Congratulations to you, Chris Melling. What a night you've had. You've produced some amazing ball over the last 4 days, none more so than that ridiculous seven ball where you're snookered, you come off the rail and potted it. What a great 4 days you've had, Chris.
Oh, it's been unbelievable. I mean, first of all, I'd just like to say, obviously, thank you to Matchroom Sport for doing everything, Barry Earn, and especially to everybody here. The crowd have been absolutely unbelievable. Thank you. It's a dream come true to win it once, but to do it twice is just unbelievable.
Well done. We'll have a few words with other players. Niels, if you want to just join me for one quick moment. How does this one rate with all of them? Congratulations.
Oh, thanks, man. This doesn't rate. This, I mean, this is the best. The heat was really on. I mean, we're up 9-6, and they come back with a lot of heart, and they left us really, really nervous. And then Chris come out, he start firing, and Nick was under so much pressure. It's unbelievable. So, I got nothing left.
Well done. Nikos Economopoulos, if you want to come over as well. You've never played in a Moscone Cup before. How on earth are you feeling?
Excuse me, tell me again, I didn't listen to you.
You've never played before?
Yeah.
What's it like?
I'm very excited. The atmosphere is very, very nice, special. I like it very much. All people here are very good. We play very well. I think we deserve to win. But the USA play also very good.
We'll come back to you.
We are very happy that we win.
I'm sure you are. Well done. We'll come back to you guys in a minute. For the time being, Moscone Cup champions, Team Europe, everyone. Where's CJ? CJ, can I borrow you for a moment, sir? Commiseration, sadly, for every winner. There has to be a runner-up. There must have been a point tonight on more than one occasion where you thought it was going to be your night.
Yeah. I mean, everything went as planned the first three matches, you know. I mean, everything was going well. We had the momentum, and then we had that key match. And it could have went either way, you know. I mean, I can't complain. The first three players did a fantastic job, and we just had a little hiccup on the fourth one. But there's next year. We got plans for them in the United States. So I hope they enjoy it. For 1 year.
1 year. Let's have a quick word with a few other players. Dennis, if you want to join me as well. I know you were so excited about tonight's session. You came out. They love you, really. They love you, really, Dennis.
But they love me. You know, it was just an uphill battle from the beginning. I'm proud of all these guys. We all struggled all week other than Johnny. And we had a chance at the end. We showed a lot of heart. Came with it today and got beat. There's not much I can say, you know. I'd like to thank Matchroom and PartyPoker.com. And next year we win.
Next year you win. Let's have one quick word with Johnny Archer, just finally from the American team. Made history, obviously, this week by making the 16th appearance in the Moscone Cup. For so long it looked like you were out, then all of a sudden tonight it looked like you were back in with it, but sadly it wasn't to be.
Well, you know, first thing I'd like to say, I'm very proud of my team. They showed a lot of heart today. We were down. And, you know, my hat's off to the European guys. They just outplayed us for the week. But, you know, the guys just showed a lot of heart today, and we grinded it hard. We were all so nervous, and we were all under a lot of pressure. And they just, you know, they're just great champions. Thanks to Barry Hearn and for putting this on, and PartyPoker.net. And thank you very much to the crowd. Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, your wonderful runners-up for this year. It's Team America. Where's Johan? Can I borrow you for one moment, Johan? Because there is the tiny matter of the MVP, the most valuable player. If you could present it to the European player who has been bouncing around for the last 4 days. He's been potting balls off lampshades and was simply amazing tonight. Put your hands together for Chris Melling, everyone. Chris, you're going to wake up soon, aren't you?
Wow, I can't believe I've won it. I mean, the first 2 days I started off very slowly. Lost 2 5-4s, which, you know, I could have easily won them. But I came good at the end, which is me always, and I always come good at the end.
Congratulations, wonderful performance from you and the rest of the gang. Ladies and gents, the Moscone Cup champions for 2012, and for the third time on the trot, Team Europe! Well, here is confirmation of the results from tonight before we get the final word from Jim White. It looked like it was going to be a cricket score, didn't it? But then Dennis Hatcher, Johnny Archer and Shane Van Boney put paid to that. They brought the score back and it looked like we were going to go to the captain's pick before Mellin produced some stunning pull. And in the end, we just saw Nick Vandenberg pop that all-important nine ball to make Team Europe champions again. 11-9 they beat Team USA. Jim White, over the last 4 days, would you say the right team won?
I think so, Andy. I think USA definitely can hold their heads high. It was a great fight back today. We all expected it was going to come. It came, and like you said, that this event had 10-10 written all over it.
Chris Mellin, the MVP, produced shots like this all night. This was just one of them. I think I said the 7-ball. It was the 6-ball. He was snookered in his match tonight. Just simply breathtaking. And he said he went for it as well, Jim.
Yeah, Chris is a player that plays with supreme confidence, and he's such a good cueist. His fundamentals are so sound that every time he comes to the table, he is capable of doing absolutely anything.
Something tells me that celebration by Team Europe may just go on until next year, when Johnny Archer and CJ Wiley have also said next year we'll take them in Las Vegas. It's going to be hard.
You know something? Team USA knows what they've got to do now. They've got to elevate their game in every facet before they get ready. The one thing that I saw, Johan coming over for the US Open, he showed the commitment that Team Europe has. He was over there recruiting players, watching players, scouting mission. This is what Team USA have to do now. They've got to show and match that commitment.
No, indeed. It's been a simply breathtaking 4 days. Thank you so much for staying with us. There are more Q Sports coming your way as well. Just into the new year in January, at the end of it, we have the snooker shootout. It starts on Friday, January the 25th from 6 p.m. on Sky Sports 2 HD and goes over the weekend. We finish Sunday night. Well, there you go. A magical 4 days. You've seen it all live here on Sky Sports. Thanks so much for staying with us. Have a lovely Christmas and New Year. And I tell you what, I know one team that will be the new Moscone Cup champions for 2012, a Team Europe. We'll see you soon.